Welcome to the CorpVault channel. In this video, we created a series of questions for knowledge check. You have 10 seconds to answer each question. Please like, share, comment or suggest. Subscribe for more videos. And you can follow us on Instagram. Question 1. The correct answer is C. Grid store technology provides the ability to configure multiple data paths to storage within a storage policy copy. Having multiple data paths enables the administrator to route data from multiple clients to storage on the best path available. Reroute data should a data path resource fail, or load balance data movement across multiple paths for performance. By defining multiple paths, the number of storage policies needed within a CommCell environment can be reduced. This will make it easier to manage backup data and help consolidate media usage. Question 2. The correct answer is B. You can add more partitions to an existing and online de-duplication database that is used by a storage policy enabled with de-duplication. For example, you can change a single DDB configuration to a two-partitioned or a four-partitioned DDB configuration, or two-partitioned DDB configuration to a three-partitioned or a four-partitioned DDB configuration. Question 3. The correct answer is B. The DDB is not used during the restore process, as the CommServe database knows which jobs belong to which store IDs. Question 4. The correct answer is A. If the primary copy becomes inoperative due to a storage media failure or a library or network malfunction, you can promote a secondary copy to become the primary copy. Promoting a secondary copy allows you to continue operations as before and make repairs without interrupting backup and restore operations. Question 5. The correct answer is D. Application read size is the size of the data read from the clients for data transfer during backup operations. By default, the application read size is set to 512 KB. Question 6. The correct answer is A. If any tape drive has gone offline, then you can check the status in resource view. Expand storage resources, libraries, tape library, and select the master pool. On the right-hand side, you will see the tape drive status showing either offline, fully accessible, or in maintenance. Question 7. The correct answer is A. The single sign-on feature enables users to log into the CommServe using their user account credentials from the Active Directory service provider, inheriting capabilities on the CommServe based on their Active Directory group membership mapping, on the CommServe user groups. The CommServe must be a member of an Active Directory domain, in order to support single sign-on logins. SSO logins are not supported if the CommServe is part of a workgroup. Question 8. The correct answer is B. You log in only once in the command line interface, using qlogin, and not for each command execution. Once successfully logged in, the session is active for 14 days, and later it is terminated automatically. Question 9. The correct answer is D. Source-side deduplication identifies and eliminates redundant data from the client, thereby reducing the data transfer over the network, which minimizes the network bandwidth consumption for backup operations. Question 10. The correct answer is A. Several services utilized by the CommVault software are designed to listen for incoming network traffic on specified network ports, thus the CommServe, media agents, and iData agents within the CommCell communicate with each other. Essential CommServe services are automatically assigned registered static port numbers during installation. Media agents, iData agents, and other software components can utilize the same default static port numbers, or any static port numbers specified during installation. Default static registered port for CommVault Communications Service is 8400, which uses TCP protocol. Question 11. The correct answer is B. Silo storage minimizes primary disk storage usage by managing the disk space and periodically moving the data to the DAP. This efficient disk management reduces the cost of storage. Silo storage can be used for long-term data preservation. Question 12. The correct answer is D. As you have three different departments, with three different extended retention requests, you create three different secondary copies with copy type selective, one for each department, and set the extended retention as requested. The less the storage policies you create, the better to manage the data. Question 13. The correct answer is D. All of the options belong to normal data aging operation, and they are not applicable for deduplicated data. For deduplication, the data is not deleted from the disk at the data chunk level, but instead at the data block level, as the data blocks within the data chunks are referenced by multiple jobs. Question 14. The correct answer is B. When you install CommVault India coupled mode, the client does not establish connections with the CommServe computer. You must register the client to complete the installation. Question 15. The correct answer is C. Q commands are a set of commands that can be executed from the command line to perform several basic operations. These commands provide access to several basic functions through the command line, and can be integrated into your own scripts and scheduling programs. You can write scripts using the available commands. We will end this video here. Let us know in comments how you did. Please hit the like button if you like this video, and subscribe to our channel if not already done so. Thank you. Do subscribe for more videos.